everyone, welcome to another Make a Card Monday video. I started out with a little bit of prep work in that I cut two circles that are 4 1/4 inch and then another circle that's 3 3/4 inches, but this one's out of some patterned paper. The patterned paper is from this 6x6 pad from Basic Gray. This is from the PB&J collection. I'm going to be using a couple different sheets out of this pad. So I'm making a circle card today. I'm using these two circles as my card base. So in order to make it into a card that will fold, I'm taking a ruler. It doesn't have to be a T-square, although mine is. You can just do whatever. I'm going to score a little bit away from an edge. I'm going to kind of fold that a little bit. And then I'm taking adhesive, and you want it to be a really strong adhesive. All right, and then you're just going to line up those circles and press it together, and then you have a card that folds open, and you also have a complete front on the, or a complete circle on the front. All right, so I'm going to take a pencil and I'm just going to mark where these folds are, and that's just going to help me know, it's going to help me keep the circle even as I work on it. So as I put things on, it'll be completely straight. All right, I'm going to take this pattern paper and I'm adhering that to the front of the card as well. I'm making a Get Well card today, so I'm using this stamp set from Paper Smooches. This is the Healthy Vibes stamp set. I'm going to take this Feel Better Soon and stamp it on some navy blue pattern paper from that 6x6 pad. And I'm using Wow embossing powder. This is the Opaque Bright White Superfine. Apparently this isn't available in the States yet. They sent it to me with my little sample pack that I showed you guys on Friday. And I think it'll be available in January. But I mentioned to them that I really needed a super fine white embossing powder, so they said they'd send it to me to try. I'm still getting a lot of stuff stuck to the paper. It might be my super dry climate. Yeah, I'm going to re-stamp that. And I'm going to end up using my powder tool. I know that they say not to, like, that you don't need to use a powder tool with this, but I'm still getting some static cling going, so I'm hoping this will help. Alright, let's see if this does any better. It did do a little bit better. I've still got a few little things hanging on, but for the most part, it does look better than this other one. I'm going to go ahead and cut this down. I have some old olive cardstock here from Stampin' Up, and also this Circle Fusion background stamp from Impression Obsession. And I'm going to stamp this on here, and I'm going to use, let's see, I think I'll go ahead and just use some old olive ink from Stampin' Up. Alright. I'll very carefully set this down so that it's lined up. I'm covering it with that scratch paper I used earlier with the embossing. Awesome impression there. All right, so here's when the, why I marked that is going to come in to play. When I put this on, I'm going to line up those pencil marks on my mat so I know that it's completely straight. And then now when I put this on, I could also use my mat to make sure that this is on here straight as well. I'm going to go ahead and put adhesive on the paper. Put that down like that. Now I can turn this over and I'm just going to trim off these ends. All right, now I'm going to stamp the Kleenex box and the tissue. I'm going to be coloring these in with colored pencils, so I'm just going to use some black Stazon ink. doesn't necessarily have to be stays on. It could be any black, but it just happens to be the one that's out on my craft desk. Lovely. I'm using the Prismacolor Premier 48 colored pencils. I'm going to use a little bit of blue on the Kleenex. That's just going to make it look like it's more white. I'm coloring in circles and I'm making sure that the areas that would be shaded are darker. You know, on second thought, I'm going to stamp the Kleenex box on this pattern paper from that same 6x6 pad. Yeah, I decided I wanted just a little bit more color on the card. So I'm going to go ahead and trim out the little box of tissues and also the top. I'm darkening the side of the box and also the top just a little bit so that it has a little bit of differentiation from the front, which is the brightest. Just a tiny bit, not super noticeable. Okay, when it comes to these little tiny pieces that you cut out after you stamped them, what I like to do is take a brush marker, black, it can be anything, it doesn't have to be a Copic one, that's just the one that I have, and I run it along the edges and it gets rid of any of the white right along the edge so that it looks like you cut it out perfectly. There's that piece right there. I'm going to do the same with this one. There's a little smiley face stamp, which I think is just adorable. And I think, yeah, it'll fit perfectly on the little Kleenex box. All right, I punched a 2.5-inch circle right there, and I'm going to use that actually for the backdrop for the Kleenex and whatever. I think that'll look just a little bit better because it'll give some contrast between the pattern of the box and the white. That'll work. All right, and to put the Kleenex on top, I'm just going to use a little tiny strip of Tombow Mono Multi-Glue, and I'm just going to put it on the very tip of the Kleenex. There we go. I'm going to finish the card with some dash lines right around the edges and make sure I erase these lines first. That's just going to help pull in that white paper. All right, and that's the card for today. Hope you guys enjoyed. Here's the folded card like that. And I will catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.